Less than a billion years ago, life crossed a threshold. Single cells started to band together, eventually evolving into the riot of shapes and functions of multicellular life today. It's been thought that the evolution of multicellularity must have been a major genetic leap, but new research suggests that it wasn't such a difficult transition after all. Scientists looked at an organism that seems closest to making this leap. Coanoflagellates, while single-celled, resemble the specialized cells that line the channels of sponges, which are considered by many to be the most primitive living animal. A lab found 350 gene families in coanoflagellates, once thought to be exclusive to multicellular animals. The findings suggest that this single-celled organism is already equipped for multicellular life. A single cell's life is simple but limited. Like hermits, microbes need only be concerned with feeding themselves. In contrast, cells in a multicellular organism give up their independence. They take on specialized functions. They sacrifice their progeny for the greater good. Take Wolverine algae, which comes in a spectrum of cellularity. A lab compared the biology and genetics of this diverse set of algae and learned that as cells banded together, existing genes took on new functions. Chlamydomonas is a single-celled alga that uses its centrioles for both swimming and reproduction, so it can't do both at the same time. Its multicellular relative, Volvox, however, can do both at once, because its cells have specialized, with some using the centriole for swimming, and others using it for reproduction. Yeast is a fungus consisting of a single cell. One lab conducted a series of test tube experiments with yeast cultures to better understand how cells evolved, increasing complexity. The biggest cells, which were the ones that settled to the bottom of the flask, were allowed to survive and reproduce. Within 2 months, daughter cells stuck to their mothers and formed multicellular structures, dubbed snowflakes because of their shape. Over time, they got bigger and more complex. In this sped-up simulation of evolution, the yeast specialized cells. In large snowflakes, certain cells undergo a type of suicide, releasing the cells at the tip to start a new snowflake. The dying cell sacrifices its life so that the group can reproduce, a hallmark of multicellularity. The team conducted the same experiment with Chlamydomonas, and again, a kind of multicellularity was quick to appear. Scientists are still debating what drove simple cells to become more and more complex. But with these genetic comparisons and clever experiments, what was once thought as a major leap can now be seen as a series of small genetic steps that led to the wondrous diversity of multicellular life today.